In your algebra class, once you've studied one-step equations for some time, you'll naturally move on to two-step equations, and that's what we're going to talk about in this video. We're going to continue to use the addition property and the multiplication property of real numbers to take our equation and add numbers or subtract numbers or multiply or divide things to both sides of the equation so that we can manipulate the expressions around to solve for x, to get your variable isolated by itself so that you can solve for the equation. Really, the main thing we have to focus on and talk about primarily is what step do you do these different operations? You know, what comes first? And the way I would describe it is like this. If you were going to, let's say, take a red, a blue, and a green box, and we were going to stack them, and you stack them reds and then blues and then greens, and then you suddenly changed your mind and you wanted to unstack them, you would not unstack them reds, then blues, then greens. You would have to do it in the reverse order. You would have to take greens off the top, then the blues, then the reds. So the way you unstack something is exactly opposite or exactly backwards or reverse from the way you stacked it. And the same is true with two-step equations. We're going to undo the operations done to x in exactly the reverse order they're applied to x. And we'll try to make this clear as we walk through some examples. So here's our first example. We're trying to solve for x. 2 times x plus 1 equals 7. Now, this is a two-step equation, and I see two things that are done to x. I see x as being multiplied by 2, and then on top of that, I see that we're adding 1. Now, let's keep in mind our order of operations. Parentheses, exponents, multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. This is the order in which things are done and your operations are applied. So if you were going to plug in a value for x, of course you would multiply it times 2 before you would add 1. But if that's the order in which things are going, as we unravel these things and we want to solve for x, the first guy to go, or the first guy we're going to take care of, is this plus 1, because that was the last thing done to x. And so how do we get rid of a plus 1? Well, we are going to subtract 1, not just from the left-hand side, but also from the right-hand side. And so we would get 2x equals 7 minus 1, which is 6. And then we'll undo the first operation done to x, which is times 2, by dividing not only the left-hand side by 2, but also the right-hand side by 2. And so we would get our answer, x equals 3. Obviously, we can check our answer. 2 times 3 is 6, and 6 plus 1 makes 7. So this is, in fact, the solution to this two-step equation. And real quick, before we go into our next example, let me just show you what would have gone wrong if we did these in the wrong order. What if we looked at this equation and we said, oh, okay, you know what? X is being multiplied by 2, so I'm going to divide by 2. Well, first of all, if you want to divide something by 2, it would have to be the entire left-hand side. You can't just divide just this one term by 2. So you can divide the left-hand side by 2 and the right-hand side by 2. But you see, now we're stuck because these 2's won't cancel because of this addition right here. The 1 had to go away before we divided by 2. So anyways, that's why you have to be extremely careful as to what order you're undoing these operations. And again, it's exactly like I said earlier, they're undone in exactly the reverse order that they're applied to x. Let's try one more example. Let's try to solve for y here. 3 minus y equals 10. So the first thing we would want to get rid of is that 3. And that 3 is being added to negative y. So we would subtract 3 from both sides. When these cancel, we get negative y equals 7. And then the y is multiplied by negative 1. There's an understood negative 1 right here. So we could divide both sides by negative 1. And if I can write this correctly, the negative 1's cancel, and so we get y equals negative 7. So these two-step equations are very, very popular. You'll see a lot of these examples. And again, it's just practice these a lot, and just remember that the operations are undone in exactly the opposite order that they're applied to x.